honored to be here and to be able to serve you as the new deputy leader for the United Conservative Party. I wanted to just raise a few points for me. Energy for me is something that is so close to my heart, just not because of the obvious reasons, but because of it defines so much of who we are in this province and what we love and how we function. And when you look at Quebec, who imports 90% of its crude from places like Nigeria that have uncontrolled releases of methane gases and emit 4 times the amount of upstream in the oil sands. And if we truly believe in climate leadership, then Alberta should be the only place. It should actually be the only place that oil and gas is produced because we are the best, we are the greenest, we are the cleanest, and we are the most responsible producers. Now, the climate plan of this province presently will show no measurable changes in GHG emissions. Mr. Binion, you are truly an amazing advocate for our industry, and I personally want to thank you for helping public servants like myself to understand our amazing resource industry and for taking the time and effort to educate us so that we are able to elevate our industry, elevate our province, and most importantly, all of our citizens. And it's amazing advocates like you and Mark Schultz of the COADC and Oil Respect Campaign and Cody Battershill of the Canada Action Campaign who are bringing clear messages out to the masses about Alberta's world-class standards for responsible oil and gas and resource development. And it's about always doing better. Always. We all know that. And it's about acknowledging how proud we should be of our resources and our development of those resources. And it's about being proud about the prosperity that these amazing resources provide to the citizens of this country. And it's about acknowledging that everything we do on any given day, our quality of life, is a result of petrochemicals. And it's about stating the fact every day, loud and proud, that Albertans care about their earth, they care about their air, and they care about their water. Being painted as embarrassing cousins, or sewer rats, or that we produce dirty oil, or that fracking is unsafe. Recently, I don't know if you saw the new article that Kenneth Green just put out, and he spoke about induced seismicity and water contamination and air pollution and the extensive regulatory process and the industry best practices. And the purposes are to help reduce the environmental impacts and to do the strong environmental assessments and address the concerns of well bores. The industry strives to do better. And the industry, has created the science behind the innovations to make our industry the best in the world. We must continue to do better. Albertans should be producing more, not less. Alberta should be the shining jewel of responsible resource development and should continue to set the example for the rest of the world and not the other way around. Our governments should be pressing the rest of the world to follow in our footsteps because we set the industry standards. Alberta should be proud of what we create, and we should be exporting that technology all over the world because, again, and it can't be said enough, we are the greenest and the cleanest, and we will continue to do so because we care about our earth, air, and water. Our children attend schools that are in the communities that develop our resources. We drink the water. We fish in those lakes. We are not perfect. But we are doing what it takes to make sure that we are constantly improving. This industry builds our schools. This industry builds our roads. This industry builds our hospitals. This industry makes life better. Alberta is a precious diamond, and any government that is willing to talk down about this province and what we produce and how we produce it is not worthy of it and does not understand Alberta. Our present government actively speaks out against the prosperity of Canada and Canadians, and it is time for this to stop.